help you make sure that this is really a trip of a lifetime. Now, you'll see all these coloured statues sitting on buckets. They had a vote in 2014, who is the favourite son for all. They are going down the mile. The Royal Mile runs from the castle at the top of the rock to the palace at the bottom of the rock. So if the Queen comes involved, but Alexander Fleming was Felicillin. So there's Walter Scott underneath his monument. Very impressive monument to me. We're going to be crossing this, driving along Princess Street tomorrow. It's the births, deaths, and marriages in there to your left. We're now about to cross the bridges. Edinburgh's built on seven hills. Yeah. Well, there's going to be 9,000 people going to the tattoo up at the castle tonight. A lot of them are here on the mile. Yeah. The door, turn left, and in the doors for our dinner venue. Stuart will be back to pick up. This is our university student area, so that is why it is so busy. They are all going in to see different, I don't know what's on in the McEwen Hall tonight, but it's obviously very popular.
Wow.
Hogwarts does not exist, it's just a little model in a studio, but she got the idea from...
But our city fathers did eventually comply. They drained out the North Lock. They laid it out as Princess Street Gardens. See the stands over there? That's where you'll be tonight. Somewhere in there. Yeah. You is the way they hang out over the gardens. They used to live. The entire area there used to be a prison. The big square building there, that's the headquarters of the civil... captured, robbing the excise office. The tax office. Probably the only decent thing he ever did in his life. Because during the day, Deacon Brodie was a magistrate, drawing our locksmith, cabinet maker, a pillar of society. During the day. But every evening he changed. He turned into a thief and a mugger. And shortly before he was captured, robbing the excise office, in his capacity as a magistrate, he presented the city of Edinburgh with a brand new set of gallows. And they worked perfectly. Where you paid your tolls to society, a tax office, and a prison. Now been turned into something useful. A tavern. And on the left here, the Canongate Kirk. And buried in the graveyard over to the left, a man called Adam Smith. The original guest house of the Abbey. But we're now going to make our way into the Queen's back garden. This is the Queen's private back garden. Well, it's not private because she opens up to the public so we can all come in here. But as we go around the corner, if you look to the left or the right, you will see the lanterns. And on top of the lanterns, you can see the crown. That denotes that you are now entering crown property. This is the Queen's back garden, but she does open it to the public. She really does. And we do the monstrosity. The ugliest building in Edinburgh. The ruination of Scotland. The new Scottish Parliament. No, No, I'm not kidding. You see the canopy above the door there? See that canopy? That's there to keep the rain off you. Just on our left, our monument to two Roman warriors. And over here on the right-hand side, a letter. He would quickly scan his mother's letters, and then he would hold them up and auction them to his classmates. He used to sell Victoria's letters to help spin out his pocket money. He used to buy things. Monday to Friday, 9 o'clock each morning, 2,000 civil servants start the day in there with a cup of tea. They pick up a piece of paper, they commute to the office next door for another, and it's built 3 stories down, so it doesn't spoil that lovely view of the double-decker bus. Or beyond the double-decker bus, the old town of Edinburgh. And there has been a church on that site since the year 854. The oldest part of that building is merely 16th century. In fact, most of the building is actually 19th century. But don't worry, the minister, he's 21st century. He's got a ponytail. And just on the left here, the monument to Sir Walter Scott, the greatest of the Scottish authors. But we are now heading into the new... Almost forgot. These gardens are what we call key gardens. And they're privately owned. When you buy a property here on Queen Street, it's about as bad as me. Anyway, he saw the children, he went over, dug a hole. Never heard of them, have you? Well, don't worry about it, because I've never heard of them either. I looked him up my books and I found out the barber, the man who cut your hair, was a man who pulled your teeth. As you go around the country and you see some of these kids with their fancy in your house, you may well wonder, have them in all colours. But looking up now to the left, you can see Edinburgh Castle. And that's where we'll be heading very shortly. But first of all, we are going to have a photograph taken. You will have a photograph taken. Is that quite clear? Good. It's a company thing, so you get over and done with as quickly as possible. We're just going to pull it to the left here, and Piper stands up on the battlements in full Highland dress, playing the pipes. And Sidia, the one with the hat on.
Right, all get
cozy. Your voice run off with the hairy Scotsman.
Gating number 6, and the four gates here sitting inside the Arch of Tower.
Place to go because they do lovely meals as well, light meals or heavy meals depending on what you like. They're reasonably priced as well.
I'll just make sure that you see everything.
Yeah, I've got it.
I've done tolerably well, yes. In times such as these, a privateer can do.
Pour être stupide, la cupidité de Cameron est infinie. Pourrait être ton plus beau archer. Une vraie petite force.
Accommodation to accommodate all the people that want to come. You get people transferring through from Glasgow to visit Edinburgh during the festival season. So I'm sure, I know some of you would rather we had a hotel on the mile, and actually we're pretty... That's the Usher Hall there, it's a big, big concert hall. We've got a couple of theatres either side. Start looking, you start finding quite a few of them. Here. So, Episcopalian, Presbyterian, one of them is now the Eric Little Center. George the Fourth Bridge, it intersects with the Royal Mile. You go up the mile to the castle. Yes, so the tattoo starts at 9. You take your... Right, so those getting off now, this is my four up the back. That's George the Fourth Bridge to our right-hand side. You walk along it towards the big green dome, and you will cross the mile up to the executions, because obviously, you know, you wanted a good audience. Now, Maggie Dixon's, there's a wonderful story about Maggie Dixon.
And dog, consecrated grounds. This was a compromise to put him here. Now, Grey Friars, who were the Grey Friars? The Franciscans, this is a monastery. Yes, so the friars, the monks here wore...
Thank you. sweat soaking through the floor. Buried in your brain is a nick that you can't ignore. Take a breath, sleep on your mind.
Whoever to himself hath said, this is my home, my native land, land of brown heath and shaggy wood, land of the mountain and the flood, land of my sires. What mortal hand could e'er untie the filial band that knits me to thy rugged strand? Scotland, Scotland the brave!
soldiers died out, a drummer would beat the signal to send them back to their billets. Do then tap to.
To have women as queens, but you didn't want it, really. So, Henry VIII is obsessed with his line. Catherine of Aragon cannot... left there, there's three hills, the Iden Hills. In the shadow you have crusade to the Holy Land. Robert the Bruce was one of the great fighters. You have the English, 700 years ago, very powerful English king is trying to take over Scotland. Yeah? So, Edward the First.
they say here,
railway viaduct over the river Treat there to your left hand side. Roadworks going on here. This is where Arthur Conan Doyle was born. The actual house in which he was born would have been on this area that is being redeveloped now, Picardy Place. So Arthur Cathedral. So we have two cathedrals. They're both called St. Mary's. One is the Catholic Cathedral, and the other was a big problem until, of course, Joseph Lister came along. Coming back down onto Princess Street. I won't necessarily, whether I use them or not depends on the weather really. They don't do so well in very wet weather or windy weather. From the time it starts, it is 6 nights a week with a matinee on Saturdays. There's no performance on a Sunday, but Monday through Saturday there's a performance.
Official state visit, Her Majesty, together with the 45 attendants.
Can you finish?
Yeah, I know, but it'll be more.
Hanging from the silver ship, which is actually the top part of a huge salt cellar, reputedly owned by the last Tsar of Russia. Presented to the officers, Victoria and Albert. In two cases, Victoria and Albert, dates from the 19th. Circular flat silver spoons at the front of the case. Second from the left is a wedding portrait of Princess Margaret and Anthony Armstrong Jones, taken in 1960 by the photographer.
Formal receptions, the resident pianist of the Royal Marines Band would sometimes provide background music as the Royal family and their guests continued their after dinner counterpart. The state visits, flowers were always provided by the host country, but for UK voices,
by the Buckingham Palace staff when they were aboard. Like the officer's sergeant, some of whom carried out security, while others formed part of the Britannia band. Admiral Horatio Hill says in the other men's areas, the bar was the focus of the room. However, as a senior yacht,
it is.
lavabo, dis donc. Puis t'as les trucs pour se raser.
Number of these private schools across Edinburgh.
And then, oh, what a glorious sight! Warm, reeking, rich.
Well, the duck wasn't that good duck. I'll tell you that.
It wasn't real good.
Yeah.